That is numerical only we can predict, numerical or continuous value. We have seen, right now we are discussing, so far now we discussed pre-processing and exploratory data analysis. For this exploratory data analysis and pre-processing, what is the data we used is house price prediction. Within the house price prediction, what we are using is we are trying to predict sale price. Sale price is what in terms of lakhs or in terms of dollars. Some price we need to fix for the house, depending upon the features, the basements, availability of number of bathrooms, and availability of garage area, something like that, VSNR area. So based on that, we are fixing the price of the house. So that's what our objective. Now, what industry standard says, if you look at this prediction model, one of the predictive model is linear regression. There are so many other predictive models are available. One is CART algorithm, classification and regression tree. Like that CART algorithm is there. KNN is also there. So many algorithms are there. MARS algorithm that I will introduce at the end of this predictive algorithm, predictive model. Then you can refer any of the model for regression building. One of the famous model is linear regression for predictive model. But the moment predictive model is used, then we need to understand what circumstances are, what is the utilization of this model in the industry. As per the benchmark report or research report, 20% only predictive models are used in the across industry or across business domain, I can say, or research domain, whatever it is. So whenever we look at classification and clustering, there are other two techniques. These three are the major techniques in the data science. One is predictive model, next is classification, last one is clustering. For each of the technique, we will be undergoing lot of models, so that you will come to know many number of algorithms for each model. This is a major branch or major titles: predictive model, classification model, clustering model. Remaining 80% of the time, industry users, whenever you are going for industrial job, you must be aware of this. So classification and the clustering are techniques are used 80%. Among that, there is no proportion. Only 20% of the industry or 20% of the time, every industry starts using or business domain starts using this predictive algorithm. That is enough. The set objective of today's agenda: what is linear regression model, regression modeling steps, and ordinary least square, that is the terminology highly we will be using across this discussion. Regression coefficient computation, finally finding the regression coefficient only we are doing with the training stage. The moment we say data model, it has two different stages, major stages. One is training stage or training model or training phase. Another one is testing phase or testing model. So that training time, it starts computing regression coefficient. That the coefficients only guides for the prediction or guides for the testing phase. And model assumptions, what are the assumptions we need to look at? So many assumptions we discussed already. One is multicollinearity check, and categorical to numerical value conversion or encoding, and normality check, outlier deduction. These are all the few stuff we started discussing. So that all over. Predict response variable. What is response variable? Y variable or predictive variable? In our case, house price prediction, the predictive variable or response variable is sales price. So that already decided. What is model? A representation of some phenomenon. It may be a statistical model. It will have some input. It processes something based on certain mathematics or certain logic, then it produces certain output. So the process input, mathematical model or algorithm, then output, then it is said to be a model. Now, what is math or stats model? These all we discussed. Now, I want to skip. Actually, the same way I used for the previous batch for teaching the foundations. Now, let us come to directly linear regression model. When we can use linear regression model? relationship between one dependent variable and explanatory variable. All the independent variables are said to be explanatory variable. What are all independent variable we discussed? Basement, square feet, garage area, so many MSR area, MSVNR area. These are all the parameters are the variable we discussed. Those all the variables said as exploratory variable or independent variable that helps for exploring the value of the dependent variable. Dependent variable means sales price. Use equation to set up a relationship. Whenever we relate, we used to study in the discrete mathematics functions. Function means there would be an input, there would be a transmission, there would be output. So there should be an equation or there should be a mandatory mathematical model for building linear regression. Numerical dependent response variable is numerical. Already we have seen it's filled with dollar value, dollar information. The price of the house is fixed with the sales price or numerical dependent variable. One or more numerical or categorical independent. Explanatory variable can be of either numerical or categorical. You look back to the data or whatever we discussed till the previous class, it's a mixed. Then what we started doing, all the categorical variable, we started converting using get dummies function. Encoding has been done. So used mainly for prediction and estimation. Linear regression is useful for prediction and estimation. Types of regression. We can use one explanatory variable. In our case, house price prediction, sales price is only one variable. We are using it as predictive variable. Independent variable, we are using 2+ explanatory variable. Very simple linear regression only will have one dependent, one independent. Both dependent variable also will be one, independent variable also will be one. Explanatory means independent variable. So simple, whenever we are using only one independent variable, that is said to be simple linear regression. So within the linear regression also, we will be having two different type, linear, non-linear. What is the meaning of linear? Whenever the slope, line equation is playing a role, any angle, the slope can be anything, but line equation will play a role. When the line equation is formed by the data and the variable, then it is linear. Not a line, slightly like this, sinusoidal like, slightly like this. This kind of equation is formed by your data, that is said to be non-linear. Data only decides whether it's going to become linear or non-linear. Model cannot have control. You need to give a regression model, you need to feed the data. Depending upon your data nature, it will take the shape, either linear regression or non-linear regression. Non-linear, all the time we need to remember, it is not a straight line. It can be any shape. It can be cubic order, or it can be exponential order. It could be anything. It doesn't matter for us. Other than the straight line, slope and intercept. The moment the slope and intercept are generated and we could able to fit the data, then it is said to be linear model, linear regression. Other than the straight line, if we get any other shape, then it is said to be non-linear model. I introduce the secret of linear regression. The entire linear regression model is working based on the principle called line equation. When we were in our childhood or schooling days, we used to study y is equal to mx plus c. This is the equation fully helps us this model. This is the background behind of or the mathematical or philosophical view behind of linear regression. This we should remember always in your mental picture. You need to relate whatever I am articulating either with the line equation or with this mathematical model. That's it. Then you are done with understanding linear regression. So linear, by this time you would have understood. This is linear. Anything comes without a line, that is called non-linear. So depending upon that linearity, they are classifying into two different types, either linear, non-linear. Depending upon the number of exploratory variable, they are classifying into simple or multiple. That's it. Whatever the diagram I have shown for that the theory. You just read it, read out. I have articulated. Otherwise, I need to read. I give just 1 minute. You can read this. Then I'll come back. Hope you would have understood. It is a relationship, linear relationship or non-linear relationship. Linear, the moment you say, it's a line equation. Non-linear, the moment you say, it's not a line equation. It could take any shape. That shape we can't predict. So depending upon that shape, again, it comes into two types, non-linear, ridge regression and lasso regression. These two are the regressions treated as non-linear regression. Now, when to use regression? Is there a relationship between the variable for the analysis? The moment anyone asks you to find out the relationship analysis, like disease prediction also in the financial data, they may relate with one thing with other thing. Investment may be related with demand. Investment may be related with supply, something like that. Is the relationship linear and how strong is the relationship? The strength of the relationship and linearity of the relationship, both are considered. That we will see slowly. Just be familiar with these all the words. How accurately can we estimate the relationship? How good is the model for prediction purpose? These are all the questions whenever comes into the problem statement or not exact this articulation. This kind of context comes, we need to adapt a linear regression model. Now, partial least square is the method we are going to use. Ridge regression, lasso regression, probably end of the course only I'll be addressing that, not right now, because so many models you need to learn after. Now what we are discussing is multiple linear regression. So means taking one variable and teaching you, it will take a lot of time, not required. Then the theory example itself that I will cover. Types of non-linear regression, polynomial regression, spleen regression. The moment we use neural network, these all treated as non-linear regression. Necessary assumption, normality assumption. That we checked, normal distribution or skew distribution, we checked and we converted using the log transmission. Mohammed, actually you supposed to do, yesterday I articulated, you need to use, there are five types of normalization you can use. One is the method I explained, that is log transmission. I asked you to do Z-score transmission, min-max transmission and predefined Python code. Have you done it? You are asking for project, no? Then yes. During the session, whatever I'm telling, that all you need to take it as an important, valuable point. That all you need to simulate and explore. Not it's like a college education, giving assignment and evaluating, like that won't happen. It's a kind of a self-motivated person coming to online training. Then we will be giving hint, do this, explore this, see the internet, copy paste, whatever we tell, that all you need to do. So the same thing you need to try with five different transmission technique. If you want, I can give the formula and coding also. End of the session, remind me, I'll give you. Okay. Then what we should do, homoscedasticity assumption. What is this? I'll tell you. A little bit tough to understand in the beginning. Normality, you hope everybody would be thorough one. If not, please be clear with me. You need to be thorough. So homoscedasticity assumption. Actually, homoscedasticity should not be available. Heteroscedasticity only should be available. What it is, let me explain. Just remember that word or see to the spelling. Then rest we will discuss. Let me take a whiteboard. See, what finally we are going to do is, you will have x-axis, y-axis. Always y-axis would be your y variable sales price. In our case, the present data set or case study, what we are taking is sales price. With this sales price, we are going to relate with one variable. Human being tend to see only one variable at a time. Machine can work in plane. Plane means it will have multi-dimension. So the moment we move to the plane, n-dimensional space, we cannot able to understand. In our sales price, house price itself, the number of independent variables are, you just count after cleaning also, it would go around 70 plus. 70 plus variable, none of the human can demonstrate, none of the human can also understand. So if you want to understand how the multidimensional plane works, what I suggest all of you subscribe or just to go to 3 brown, 3 blue, 1 brown. Just type in your YouTube, search 3 blue without space, 1 brown. This is across the globe, number one YouTube channel referred by all the artificial intelligence data science, number one across the globe. Understand? So understand the importance. This is the channel explains in the n-dimensional space how things are working. All the mathematical principles required for data science and artificial intelligence, this explains a lot with a lot many animations and articulation. Please watch the stuff related to linear regression, or I will share the link also. Maybe in the document itself it is available. That is fine. Now coming back, y variable, we need to consider one variable at a time. For example, we can consider one of the variable total square feet. That is what we, after feature engineering, we calculated total square feet of the house. This square feet, one variable, let us consider. What we supposed to do? Line equation. Y is equal to mx plus c, we need to do. For y is equal to mx plus c, we need to calculate m. We need to calculate c. Just to recall, I will be teaching, no need to worry. Just recall your childhood days. It has a lot of steps to calculate slope and intercept m and c. So to do m and c, we need to do lot many more steps. Imagine somehow you started doing MNC calculation. How that MNC comes is given the data set. The data set what we are having is 2000 and something, 200 data we are having, around 2200 we are having, maybe less, plus or minus, don't worry. It's 2000 data we are having in our data set. Put together all the data only, you can calculate MNC. Not with 4 data, 5 data. The entire data set or variable or the column will help us to calculate MNC, slope and intercept. So using that, somehow cleverly, you are drawing slope and intercept. One line. Slope and intercept only decides the line. Intercept tells you where it should touch on the y-axis. Slope tells you the angle. Now this is over. If you look at your data, you have x variable. This is called x variable. X is called total square feet. You have y variable. You will have some entry. For example, you may have 20 here. You may have 300 here. Some entry you will have. Some numerical value you will have, that is for sure. Even though it is categorical variable, you are transforming that categorical variable into encoded variable. Then again, you are converting it into numerical variable only. So it will have two different data point. What it does is, once the MNC are fixed, it will go and plot X and Y for the first row. I am going to do Rangoli now for the first row. Similarly, for the second row, you will have some data that may fit here. One point may fit on this line itself. One point may come here. One point may come here. For the 2200 records, you need to plot like this. Understand? 2200 record, we are plotting like this. It may come here also. It may come here also. It will come somehow. This is what happening in the linear regression. Still more concepts you need to understand. This is holistic picture I'm giving. That's fine. If you look at this, all the pattern, whatever the Rangoli I have put, that all the pattern, there is no homoscedasticity. Homo means some pattern, some similarity, some resemblance it will take. There is no pattern. Look at very random in nature. That such kind of situation is said to be heteroscedasticity. Now, what is a Rangoli I have put within that blue boundary is heteroscedasticity. It is permitted for the linear regression model building. If it takes pattern, I will draw now pattern. X and Y variable, same philosophy. You need to have some equation, line equation. Let us have line equation like this. Then you are plotting. Let us plot. Now I am going for different Rangoli. Look at the pattern. It is. When I plot, the points would take this kind of pattern. Some pattern it will come. It could be a bird pattern, or it could be umbrella pattern, or it could be anything. Some relationship, some automatically some pattern will be formed among those all points, data set. Then again, after this, it may come down to 2 also. After this, it may come down to 1 also, anything. See, now it has pattern. Exactly how I do Rangoli at my home, it is there. So this pattern is not permitted. The pattern it is formed, it is called homoscedasticity. That word what we have seen. So once this confirmation is done, only then it will go for coefficient, regression coefficient prediction. This all will be taken care by Python code, but you should know what's happening inside. Assumptions, necessary assumptions for building regression model, we should be aware of it. We are doing manually for one-to-one variable, total square feet and the sales price prediction. Whenever the data point X and Y are plotted after finding out MNC, it should not take any regular pattern. It should not have uniformity, or it should not have some predictability. Assumptions should not have. It should be merely random. Only then it will proceed with further model building. Suppose if it has pattern, wrong prediction will happen during the future data or during the testing time, then business would go to different direction. That is the reason we need to check this homoscedasticity. It should be heteroscedasticity, or it should not be, whatever the word you want you use. Now I am giving a pass. If you have doubt, you can ask towards this homoscedasticity or heteroscedasticity. Pooja ma'am, Rajini ma'am, any one of you, if you have doubt, you can ask. If you don't have doubt, or you can put a chat box, no doubt also. Guys, are you there?
Yes, ma'am, we are there.
Ma'am, I'm not able to get, ma'am, breaking your voice.
Hello?
Rajini ma'am, Haley, Mohammed, any doubt? Guru, Pooja ma'am, is it clear? We haven't entered into linear regression at all, but before that, this assumptions comes, then I need to explain you that word. I need to explain you.
In this the outliers also comes, right, ma'am? So we have to neglect those outliers.
Outlier treatment and all would go before itself. Even outlier comes, outlier will not be considered. It's a holistic picture. It is after transformation.
Okay. So we won't have any
transformation. Pooja ma'am, okay. Still my voice is breaking, Pooja ma'am. Text me. Yes or no? Still. Ma'am. Now is it clear? I am raising my level best. I am talking from my belly.
Hello, ma'am.
Yeah. Yeah, it's good now. Fine.
You can hear me now.
Yeah. Fine.
Yes.
See, I will explain you once again. First, what it does is, it will start doing... 1 minute. Where is this annotation? Yeah. It will start... calculating mx plus c using x data. It will start doing mx plus c. I will tell you little bit later how mx plus c is done, how m is calculated, c is calculated. Before going for linear regression model building, what Python internally does. This is what it starts having this kind of assumption. If the assumptions are met, it will proceed with model building. If not, there would be a transformation taken place. Now, what it does is, it will start predicting M and C. M and C are coefficients, line coefficients. So these are regression coefficient also you can consider. These two regression coefficients are used for line drawing, this line drawing. After line drawing, your original data is there. No, that original data 20 and 30, let us assume 20 and 300 for the first record or first row. Similarly, for the second row, 10 and 200, something like that, we will assume, or 210, something like that, let us assume. For every pair of X and Y, it will start plotting in this graph, in the plane. P-L-A-N-E, plane. It will start plotting it. The plot of all the points should not take any regular pattern, similarity, shape. Then it is permitted. Then testing phase you can go. Testing can be done. RMSC can be calculated. Model validation. Whether how best your model or how worst your model, that analysis will happen. For example, I will conduct you test. After your examination, I will sit and give you closure and reflection, how bad you are, how good you are, where you need to improve, how you need to improve. Where that is called here also, there is a model. That model itself, training and testing. In real life, imagine being a student, I can't conduct you a test first. First, I need to train you. The training only is happening every day. I haven't even started testing you. Definitely within a couple of days, I started testing you through assignments, whatever. So after test, what I supposed to do? I need to validate you. How good you performed in the test. How bad you performed in the test. That is called validation. After validation, what I supposed to do? I supposed to think of improving method. How can I improve your score? Or you need to think how you can improve your score, something like that. The same steps only will happen in the data science also. Now training is happening. After training only MX plus C is formed. M and C are formed after training. So after M and C, you will be plotting the original data along with the M and C slope or across the line. In that plotting, you should not take any similarity, any pattern or any shape. It should become random in nature while plotting. This plotting will happen in the plane. Three-dimensional plane, n-dimensional plane. Now I am doing for only one-dimensional plane. So if at all happening that plotting time, this kind of pattern, this second type. This is second type, this is first type. First type is called heteroscedasticity. That is permitted. Second type is called homoscedasticity. That is not permitted. Further testing phase further. What is the meaning is, in your testing time or training time, some pattern of some topic only you are able to understand. Rest all you are not at all able to understand. That is a kind of, I'm trying to give some analogy. I'm not sure how much I'm correct, how much you are understanding correct. That is fine. So okay. It should not have any pattern. You try to understand, you while training, you need to understand lot many things. If you have some pattern, first topic I am understanding, second topic I don't know, third topic I'm understanding, fourth topic I don't know. It is a strange behavior. I should be very careful with you. Randomly, if you are telling this topic is tough, that is fine. So if you start finding, if I start finding some pattern while training, what is the meaning? Day one, you all are telling, yes, everything I understand. Day two, you all are telling, I'm not able to understand. Day three, you are all telling, I'm able to understand. It's a strange behavior, no? Could you get my point, what I'm telling? Randomly, if you ask question, if you ask doubts, that's fine. One day telling that everything I'm understanding, another day I'm not understanding. Another day I'm understanding. This is called pattern. That pattern should not be there during training phase in the data also. If there is no pattern, I can go for testing. Then after testing, model validation and so on. That is another story. Now come to this one word only I'm trying to explain. That is called heteroscedasticity. Our homoscedasticity is not permitted. Please understand. Let us move back to this one word is over. Random cloud, you see a funnel shape or some other pattern. If you see any pattern that is not at all permitted, that is called homoscedasticity. If there is no pattern, random behavior, that is called heteroscedasticity. Independence assumption. Again, this is also based on homoscedasticity only. So that only I invested this much time to make you to understand what is homoscedasticity. Now let us move on to the next topic. Multicollinearity. This we discussed. So more than one variable should not start explaining with the same correlation value. It should not have same. It can have different. At least 0.2, 0.3, 0.4 difference it can have. Not exactly the same. So that need to be taken care. You can try with multicollinearity also. Without multicollinearity also. What works best, you can take decision. See, these are all the assumption. Missing value imputation. Yes, we did. After doing these all only, we can touch upon linear regression. That is why postpone linear regression. Exploratory analysis itself, we explored a lot of duration. Dummy variable or encoding. Normality check. Normality check you can do. If there is no normality you found in it, you can use min-max transformation or result score transformation or log transformation or the inbuilt Python code. Inbuilt Python code permits or helps for a lot of transformations. Outlier deduction and removal. No outlier should be there. That yesterday we ended with outlier only. Multivariate normality, normality error, otherwise called variable inflation factor. I said multicollinearity can be checked with two different methods. One is the method called correlation. Another one is the method called VIF, variable inflation factor. I don't touch upon. If I start teaching VIF, it would take minimum 3 hours. So it's not required. Already multicollinearity check has been explained. You need to use one strategy. That's it. Once breadth of the data science, if you are acquainted, then you go for depth. See, constant error variance, independence of variance, errors versus autocorrelation versus independence assumption. This is the title. For under the title only, that whiteboard discussion I made. It should not have any homoscedasticity. No pattern should be seen. It should be heteroscedasticity. See, in the class also, if you start seeing some pattern, poor students sitting together and gang is formed, that pattern if you find, you cannot handle your class smoothly. You need to shuffle your student. Never ever they should form the gang. Then always they will try to pull you. So it's a kind of same behavior only we are trying to do here. No pattern should be there. Random behavior only permitted for the model building. Linearity. Now we are moving towards the mathematics, normal equations. This you can read, you can understand. Again, the formula, flow chart or the strategy for linear regression. Formulate the problem, fit the model, validate the assumption, then evaluate the fitted model. For the evaluation, you can use either goodness of fit test or RMSE calculation, error calculation. If it is okay, you stop the process. If not, you need to evaluate or say. Now let us see. To formulate the problem, choose a set of variable, form a model, form of model, method of fitting, specific assumptions. So far now we discussed a lot of assumption, no normality, we solve. Set of variable, how many x variable, how many y variable, form of model, whether it is linear model or any other model, which model you want to use. Then method of fitting, so what way you are going to fit. Fit is a word. Always we should be careful or we should handle it careful in data science perspective. Every time we fit the model, linear regression we are trying to fit. See what I did, I started drawing one slope, then started plotting all the point, I am fitting to it. This after fitting I will calculate the RMSE, the error or goodness of fit. So this is called fitting. Every data point, how best it fits to the line, that is called fitting. Slowly, I am going to take you to the linear regression. Don't worry. Again and again, the holistic picture I'm trying to give, so that the holistic picture only will make you to understand what I'm going to tell. The next, use method of fitting. Any method. We are going to use a method, OLS method, ordinary least square method. Or you can say, one more method, it is called residual method or residual plots. There are two words we are going to use for this, residual plots. Yeah, it is there, residual plots. Then outlier detection, sensitivity analysis. These are all the things we need to assume for further proceeding also. Validation or accepting whether that model is good or bad, or right or wrong, evaluation. So these are all the assumptions we should have. This is a flow chart, holistic picture. Let us go and see individual component. Now, 1 minute, here no power. I'm sweating, I'll put off. If you look at this grammar, units versus minutes. So only two parameters or two variables we are considering. As I said in the previous example, sales price versus total square feet, I said. Similarly, here the example, classic example or whatever they considered, x-axis is towards units, y-axis is towards minutes. So for this data set, they will be finding the coefficient. How they are finding the coefficient? Look at this. There is a constant term beta naught, beta 1. This is what coefficient? I have written it as mx. Mx, this is mx, this is c. 1 minute. This is equivalent to c, this is equivalent to mx. The symbol notation only changes. Data science, you will not see maximum mx. You will see beta 1, beta 2 or beta naught. These kind of words only you will see. Always beta naught is treated as a constant and beta 1 is treated as a slope. This is called error. Epsilon I is called error. Then that they are rewriting. Epsilon I, that error, how they are calculating, they are bringing the formula to you. That error they are taking into, always there will be error. See, after fitting, this is the error. I will put another color. This is error. This much distance is there. Here, if you look at it, sits on the same line. This also sits here. There is a error. There is a error. You can't exactly fit. Although the same data is used for M and C calculation, but the error is less appreciating. When you do, it will come like these points. It will sit far away. Then the error would be more. This is called residual error. Then fitting this line is called ordinary least square. That's it. Now they are rewriting the formula. Then they are taking square on both end. Then after taking square, they can, you can leave like this, or you can reformulate the equations, whatever the form you want. Then how do you calculate that beta 1, beta naught, or mx plus c? Beta naught is our c, beta 1 is m. This is the formula you need to use. Xi is a particular point. X bar is a mean. Yi is a particular point. Y bar is mean. And Xi is a particular point. X bar is a mean square. Then beta naught is equal to y cap minus beta 1 x cap. This is a formula. Using this formula only, we need to calculate mx, m and c. Then we need to calculate error. How much error we have got. If we got more and more error, we need to tune the model. Then if that model is not able to be tuned, we need to change the model. We need to use different model for the prediction. So this is what the stages. Now let us go to that. Whenever you are using univariate, whatever I discussed is called univariate. Line equation is used. Whenever you are using bivariate, you are using 2D plane. So this is hyperplane. Whenever multivariate, this word very beginning itself I introduced. Variate means number of variables you use. In our case, sales price and the total square feet, that one analogy alone, it is called univariate. One versus one. One independent variable, one dependent variable I used. So it is called univariate. Next is bivariate. Next is multivariate. Multivariate, even 2D plane, we can try to explain. Somehow it is possible. Both instructor and student are capable enough. 2D plane can be explained. But hyperplane, no one can explain. I'm not comfortable. I don't know also. ML does the job for us. That is why we are all behind of machine learning. Hyperplane is taken care by ML packages, that is SkyPy. SkyKitLearn, that is a hero of machine language. SkyKitLearn will take care of this multivariate analysis or hyperplane. See, ordinary least square for multiple linear regression. The moment we use multiple, it is called hyperplane. This is one of the example for hyperplane. All the points are plotted. The residuals are calculated. The distance between the plot and the plane is said to be error or ordinary least square or residual error. Again and again, I am trying to tell the almost I covered linear regression, but I need to walk through the entire document for your more clarity. There is an equation mx plus c. We need to understand this is called slope. This is called intercept. The same I said, where your line cuts or touches the y-axis is called intercept. The angle in which the line is drawn is said to be slope. What is the meaning? These are all one more question you will ask in all the competitive exam. Change in y direction will change in x direction. Whatever the change in x direction will affect the amount of change in y direction. What is the amount it will affect is m amount. M amount it will affect. If there is any change in x direction, that will affect the y also change in direction for the amount called m. Linear regression model, we need to understand every component. Now, instead of mx plus c, we are going to this, that's all. Random error, error. However, your data is perfect, data scientist or analyst is perfect, there will be a random error because we are drawing a line. After drawing a line, we are plotting. We are plotting each and every point, that point where sits. Sometimes it will sit exactly on the line. Sometimes it will sit far away from the line. So that distance is said to be error. That's distance error only. Here two terminology: OLS, ordinary least square, or residual plots. These kind of errors are residual error, residual plot or error, both are same. So these kind of errors are definitely will be available. Anybody says I'm getting zero error, you should not trust that guy in the data science at all. At least you should have the error 0.1. Anybody says I am having 100% accuracy, that guy is bluffing. He is not at all a data science. Nobody in the data science can get 100% accuracy or 0% error. There must be at least 0.1% error, only then the real data science. So that error is called this random error. Population slope, this is called slope. This is called intercept. This is called dependent variable. This is called independent variable or explanatory variable. Please understand this component. I'll just wait for 1 minute. Look at this, understand this. This is essential for articulation. Is this okay? These all our childhood parameters only, but here we are flipping this into different terminology. Independent variable, or in childhood also independent only they will tell. The new terminology is explanatory variable. Similarly, dependent childhood also they will tell. Response variable is new terminology. This is slope. You imagine if you feel difficult, you imagine C and M instead of this. That's it. Then whenever we fit a line, we form this prediction. Why is called a predictive variable? There would be error all the time. There will be error, negligible error or major error. Some error will come. Now again the same independent variable, slope, intercept, linear component. This is called linear component. That is why it is said to be linear regression. This is called linear component. What is linear component is mx plus c. Now let us slowly discuss random sample population. So normally entire population we cannot do random or regression model. We will take random sample and we will do. This is called error. This all I have explained already, but again and again I'm trying. See, we are plotting after mx plus c, we are plotting x and y parameter or x and y value. The value which is given in the data sheet. I am giving the Excel sheet, no? That one you need to pick up y. In y, it is sales price for us now. Then any one variable x you need to pick up. This point and this point, you need to point. You need to plot here after drawing a line equation. Then you will get this one. This has no error because this point sits exactly on the line, no error. Then rest of the points, see how much error. This has lot of error, random error. This has very minimal error. This is next minimal error. This also very minimal error. Here we have again huge error. So these two plots leads to error. Definitely it will be there. Not all the point cannot sit on the same line. If at all sits also, that is also one of the pattern called homoscedasticity. Then you should not proceed at all. If after plotting, if it has pattern, you should not proceed. Now there is no pattern. Everything is random. So it is called heteroscedasticity. So I can proceed enough. Again and again, the same error, observed error. Now let us see the calculation. X, Y value. Imagine anything. Now we are taking one calculation point of view. then we need to do a summation or summation. Again, we need to do a summation. X square, we need to do a summation. Y square, we need to do a summation. X into Y, we need to do a summation. Then after doing this all, we need to use this formula. N into number of point into summation xy minus sigma summation. This formula we need to use. Then we need to substitute the calculated value. Then it will give you C and M. No need to do this manual calculation at all. That is not the role of data scientists. We need to understand this. Then you are fitting that value into this equation. This is so prediction does. What is the prediction? I will tell you once again now. You are having a line equation. In the testing time, y value will not be available. You will have only x value. Then you need to predict the value, or you need to predict finally. After plotting x, you need to plot x alone. That x after plotting, at what point it meets y, that is called y. This is so prediction model or linear regression is working. Suppose another x point is here. Only x point, with a control of x point, only I'm doing. So I need to look at where it goes and intersects that y component. This is how the prediction value is coming into the picture. How this prediction value is coming into the picture? The training coefficient and the x and mx plus c, this component will help for testing data. Training coefficient only fix the line, then it fits the data x line, x point. That the x point will be projected on the y line. That y line, wherever it meets out, that is what your real value. See, y is equal to mx plus c. X value, if you substitute, if you know, substitute, it will predict y value. This is how prediction is happening. In our childhood, what we studied, that concept only we are using. Nothing more newly we are using. Again, error calculation. It is going to fit the value x into the line equation. 0.6 into 1 plus 2.2 mx plus c, x value. Then it gives a value. That value is called predicted y value. The original y value, predicted y value, the difference if we calculate, that is called residual error. The distance between the actual and the predicted value. After calculating this y only, you need to go and calculate with your original value. What is the difference between there? You may be getting 2.5. Then that 0.3 is the difference. That 0.3 is called your residual error, 0.3. Here you may have 3.4. Then there you may be having 3.8. Then minus 0.4. So to avoid this only, ordinary least square, we are squaring it. That equation itself I have written in the beginning. Squaring, why it is done? Otherwise cancellation would happen. This point and all we discussed in the beginning itself. Why we are going for square root? Why we are going for the negation and the plus whenever comes? We are squaring it. The same concept only you need to extend here. Again, it calculates the error. Y predicted, y minus y predicted, and the square of y minus y predicted. Summation of all the error is said to be 2.4. This 2.4 is the sum of square value or the residual value or error. Finally, you can say simple term, it is error. The our error amount is 2.4 in this case. Let us see what is a permitted error in the data science model later on. This is called ordinary least square. The word ordinary least square means, ordinary least square means we need to do like this. We need to plot M and C, then all the points we may need to plot, then the distance we need to calculate. This strategy, this technique is said to be ordinary least square method. Model validation. How we need to validate whether our model is right or wrong? Either you can use residual plot. See, this is uniform variance. It should not be, it is permitted. Heteroscedasticity is permitted. This is, see, look at, it has a shape, funnel shape. Then the moment the funnel shape comes, then immediately we should not proceed. homoscedasticity is best for linear regression. Heteroscedasticity we should not use. This is square error. Then every error we need to square, otherwise that plus and minus will be cancelled. Then coefficient equation, beta 1, beta 0. It is repeating again and again. So next, this is a squared error formula. The beginning itself we have seen. We started introducing one term in the mx plus x equation, that is error term. That error term we started rearranging, then the formula is formed. Interpret the same only. Now how we can finally measure the model is good or bad? Model validation step we have come. Model validation step, only two method in linear regression. One is calculating RMSE, another one is goodness of fit. What it is, in the RMSE, error should be zero, towards zero. Error should be zero is the best model. If the error is zero means best model. If it is not possible 99% of the time zero error, nearby you can get 0.1. But what the model says, RMSE value goes near zero or towards zero, your model is best. If it goes near one, your model is worst. So much error it has. Goodness of fit is opposite. Goodness of fit, if it is one, it is best model. That is 100% it can explain the model. Explain the model or predict the model. 100%. If the obtained value is 0.8, let us assume, that is a significance call. 80% of the time your model predicts well. Model is well, or your model prediction is well. If it is zero, there is no prediction, your model is absolutely waste. It is opposite to RMSE, be clear. Any one test you can use, or both of the test you can use, that is better. If you do both of the calculation, you can take optimized decision. So with this, we are concluding whether your model is good or bad, depending upon RMSE value or goodness of fit value. If both are going wrong, what we should do? Another question. You need to improve the model, tune the model. Model tuning has lot of techniques. Tuning the model, we have lot of steps, lot of techniques. Once after tuning the model also, if it is not working well, you need to change the model. Another model, there are lot of models available for the predictive technique, KNN, CART technique, something, so many other techniques, Mars algorithm and all available. You need to change the model. So this is the conclusion of linear regression or mathematical view. Lower values of RMS indicates better fit. R square, otherwise called goodness of fit model. Both are same. You need to compute R square value. That R square value will always between 0 to 1. 0 indicates worst model or poor fit. 1 indicates good fit. That 1, if you are getting 99% or 0.99, you have achieved a great. Or if you obtain 0.95, that is the best performance you got it. Then another example. See, this is where whenever the linear, this problem statement you read, I just pause for a while. You read this problem statement, then I will come to the discussion. This context will help you when or what circumstance you can use linear regression. of the, this is the topic, fixing the price of the food and services, food and beverages. See, the same pale puri I used to eat at our college, the cost is different. There is nearby city I go, and Narsapur I will go and eat, the price is different. Same pale puri I will go and eat in Karachi bakery. That Karachi bakery is one of the famous bakery of Hyderabad. That Karachi bakery, the same pale puri, they will be charging 150 rupees. What makes the difference? You can understand. My campus pale puri is different rate. Narsapur pale puri is different rate. Karachi bakery pale puri is different rate. The service, the location, the decoration, quality of the food, rating of the food given by the previous customers, all together only it fixes the price. Similarly, you can predict if you are going to run a pale puri shop, you can fix the price depending upon the location, depending upon the service which you are providing, decoration. Whenever we eat at our college, there is no AC. We need to stand and eat. It's kind of buffet system. Narsapur also the same. That would be much more worse. In the street, we need to stand and eat. When I go to Karachi bakery, the ambience would be much more appreciating, very aesthetic, appeal. AC will be there. The services, what they are doing would be awesome. So the charge which I pay would be 25 rupees pale puri. I would be charging, or I would be giving 150 rupees, same quantity. So for that situation, you can fix the price. Menu pricing in restaurant of the New York. Because price prediction. Whenever they are just relating correlation analysis, we did with correlation analysis with numerical value. Here they are doing correlation analysis with the visual. Whenever there is a linear relationship exists, more correlation exists between dependent and independent, you can proceed. That is the significance. If very lesser correlation, less than 20%, less than 30%, if it gives, we need to throw that variable. For that they are doing. So this just analogy I'm bringing, nothing I'm doing. The price of the food and services, fixing the price, you can use linear regression model. This we need to discuss later. This is the point. After testing and training, maybe tomorrow class I can discuss, not now. Underfit, best fit, overfit, variance, bias. These are all the terminology. Should be like a water. Sorry, there was a call, so that it started disconnecting. I need to mute that call. So based on this all only, we can decide the error. So already it is there, no need to write again. Variance, error, optimal, overfitting, underfitting, model complexity, number of parameters, bias. we can even decide how many parameter we can use in our model. That decision also we can use based on this plot. Number of parameters. Suppose if you are clueless, you have 70 parameters, then it will tell number of parameters only. It will advise you better to use 60 parameter. It will tell nearby, near to 60, you can either use 58 or you can use 72, something like that. Then which parameter you need to eliminate, that you only need to take decision intuitively. Now model will not tell. Number of parameters it will fix. If you start plotting, these are variance, bias, total error, underfitting value, overfitting value. These all if you plot, it will tell you the exact, the middle point will tell you number of parameters to be used. Then K-fold cross validation. I request you to watch the previous videos, previous batch video also. That was the batch conducted for industry people. So they would be asking a lot of questions or a few questions which is relevant to the industry point of view. So I'd be answering for that. So you please look into that kind of video also, not only for your session. Or better to look at the previous batch video itself. Forget about your session. So that is more than enough. You attend my session, then watch the previous batch video. Today comments are shared. Please confirm whether that all links are working or not. Watch the previous batch video, that is more than enough. That would go a little bit fast also. Your video, if you watch, it goes slow. You may feel bored. Then K4 cross validation. I will tell you now itself. What is cross validation? We need to understand. We are splitting the data into test and train and test. Several times I insisted. Train again further divided into X train, then Y train further. Then test also divided into X test and Y test. Something like this. That variable under don't bother, that letter, that just understand four way we are splitting. While splitting train and test only our problem. X train, Y test, Y test, we no need to worry. What is the problem we will be facing? Just imagine. What will happen is, test and train, when I split among 2200 data, what will happen? I'll tell you. In our college, we have five sections, five intake. So around 400 students are there in the CSE department. What is the problem will happen is, the order or the procedure rules followed by the institution is alphabetical order. All the A boys and girls starting with the A letter will start, all will be grouped into A section. Then the next, subsequently, we will form 66 students in a class. It may go with the C, B to a J also. That is fine. After J, we will form another section. What is the story I'm trying to tell is, just because of the alphabetical order, we tend to see there would be a section absolutely nonsense and misbehavior would be doing. There is a section, that section behavior would be more perfect, more learning inclination students will be there. There is another section, that section would be a mixed of that, mature students also, progressing students also. These are all the difficulties we are facing. We are not forming the class based on their IQ level. Based on their alphabet, we are forming five sections. Because of that, knowingly, unknowingly, such kind of groups are formed. What is the problem here? Tell me, this is real-time scenario. Never the entire section is performing well, that is appreciating. Our half section is performing well, half is mischievous also, okay. One particular section, entirely very ridiculous, lazy, the dullest student, no charming attitude. You know, right now the batch which I'm handling, I'm suffering a lot. Section E for the third year, I'm handling compiler design. I started feeling that why I have taken this job. Such a worst attitude they will show. Never they will respect, never they will listen, never they used to be obedient. This happens why? Because of the rules which is passed that alphabetical order. Understand, there is a relationship for this, my story and training and testing data. What we are trying to do is train and test. First, we are splitting for the modeling. It will choose one order. one by one. First one leave one and collect one, something like that. It will follow and it will pull out that combination as one of the bunches train, another bunch as a test. What will happen is training data, all the data, sorry, gone, 1 minute. Yeah, training data, all the good data goes, what will happen? Testing will become poor. Our testing should be good enough. It is like my E section only, to whom I am handling, almost over. Yesterday the syllabus completed, no more association for them. So the testing data will go wrong. Training data will be more intelligent, means testing data will look like a idiot. It should not be. So that what is the k-fold validation is, given the data set 2200 data, it will divide into, let me fix k-fold into 5-fold validation. It will divide into 5 partitions. What will happen? Among this 5 partition, it will start taking the proportion. If you mention 70-30 proportion, it will divide. First, it will consider these 3 blocks as a train data, these 2 blocks as a test data. Then it will start, what to say? You need to give the command in Python for k-fold validation. What it does? It will fit the model, it will build the regression model, and it will validate the RMSE value, R square value, or goodness of fit value. Then next iteration, next trial, what your machine does is, it will start choosing these 3 as a train data, these 2 as a test data. This is called k-fold validation. It will fold all the combinations. It will try for the best or which combination the accuracy is more or error is less, that model will be appreciated. That is called k-fold validation. Now, instead of this, if I would have done IQ analysis or their behavior analysis, I would have mixed the proportions for the 5 sections. I would have mixed it properly. 80% or 70% good student, 30% Michi student. Another section, some nearby, 60 students good student, 40 students Michi student. Something like that. Equal, more or less equal proportion I would have done. Instead, what the institution follows? Alphabetical order. In that, suddenly it happens, one of the class used to be highly demotivated. Especially the E section where I am going, one guy is not ready to talk to another guy. Lot of gangism, lot of ego. They are into third year. So that kind of eruptions will come. That avoid that, we need to go for k-fold cross-validation. Splitting the training and the testing data only, this much story. Nothing more. If we split only one way, what will happen? All the good data will go and sit in the train. Then testing will become waste. Very, very poor kind of report it will give. Your RMSE will go wrong. Your R square will go wrong. If all the good data goes and or one pattern of data, no good data, bad data, one pattern of data will go and sit in the train. That pattern will mislead your test. So that you need to put different combinations of training data set, testing data set among 2200 data. That is what cross validation takes care of. See, look at training set, validation set, testing set. It will consider data set it into different approach. That concept is enough. Model building, again and again the same. Remove the imputation value, create the dummy variable, then check for p-value if you use VAF. If you don't use VAF, greater than 5 is the VAF value, you need to consider. Now, sorry, you need to drop. If the VAF value is greater than 5, you should eliminate that variable. Improving model. If your model, everything you did well, beyond that your model RMSE or R square is not going good, then what you should do? You should do regularization method, either loss or regression, ridge regression, elastic net, edge regressor or extra tree regressor, voting regressor, stacking regressor, or else hyperparameter tuning or k-fold validation. These are all called model improving technique within the linear regression. After doing these all also, if it is not improving, nothing you and me cannot do. We need to change the model. So we understood RMS value and R square value. RMSC is too huge. Then R square is also less. This is opposite, inverse proportion. RMSC and R square both are inverse proportion. If it is worst, it should be good. If it is good, it should be worst, something like that. So after doing this, we found that our model is worst model, not at all good, appreciating. Then what we should do? We should use regularization technique, elastic net, boosting tech, regression, boosting regression technique, voting regressor, stacking regressor, hyperparameter tuning, k-fold validation. Now it all will scare you. Once we understand the model building, read this document, understand every corner of this. After this session, you can watch randomly one or two YouTube video also on linear regression. So different articulation, different strategy may help you to understand this linear regression. Initiativeness have been done now. Or watch the same video what I am articulating. Once you watch, then I recommend to watch couple of somebody's video also. Yeah, with this we are completing the theory background for linear regression. Tomorrow for first 10 minutes I'll clarify your doubts. We go for your coding. That coding will take only 20 minutes or half an hour articulation. With that, today I wanted to complete. Tomorrow again we meet by 4:40 or 4:30. Any doubts or anything you want to clarify, I will share this right immediately to the session. You can walk through this content. And I request you to watch my previously recorded session, not this today's session, whatever I'm telling. Then you watch anybody else's video. Because every time I'm attempting with a different analogy, you may grasp in any method. You don't watch this video again. Watch my previously recorded video, linear regression. Any doubts, you can open up.
Ma'am.
Pooja, ma'am. Rajini, ma'am. Guru, Mohammed.
Hello.
Yeah.
Ma'am, regarding those pattern, ma'am.
1 minute power failure. I'll put on my speaker. I may not able to understand what you are speaking. 1 minute. Yeah, you can speak now.
Regarding those pattern, ma'am, homo and hetero. You were telling about the model, yeah, right? Yeah. How can we get to know the pattern, ma'am? If it in
using Python command, we can see that stochasticity value. Using Python command, it is possible to see. I will include that code also in tomorrow session. I will find out that. Right now, in the notebook, what I am using, it is not available. You can find out through the pattern. You need to visually plot and see. There is no other numerical way.
Okay. Just by looking at the graph only, we can determine.
Yeah.
Hello, ma'am.
So otherwise, tomorrow I will give you the clarity. Finding out homo and hetero stochasticity, I will give you the clarity tomorrow.
Okay.
Ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Hetero stochasticity and homo stochasticity, we can have the p-values for these, right?
Yeah, that I will find out and tell you, ma'am, tomorrow.
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
BAF, you can have p-value. Yeah. That homo stochasticity, hetero stochasticity, numerically what to do, never even I thought of. Because of your questions, I'm just holding and I'm going to revisit myself. Only graphical method only I used to think of interpreting.
Okay. Ma'am, it was, past, I have studied in econometrics.
Okay.
Saying that the linear combination, the combination that is the residuals, what are the residuals shouldn't be, you know, heterostochastic in nature, right?
Exactly, ma'am. That residuals only we are telling. It should not take any pattern. It should not have any behavior. It should be random in nature.
Okay. Thank you.
That part only we are discussing. The residual plot only we are discussing. That graphically, that only I'm telling, this is not that residual. There will be a line, then okay. You will be plotting rangoli.
Yes.
In technical, it is called residual plot.
Residual plot.
So this.
Okay.
This should not take any regular pattern. See, no regular. Although these seems regular pattern, this is different. Okay. These are all different.
Okay.
It should not take pattern. That's it. See, kind na in a class also, if something gang is formed, no, we will we are all will be afraid.
Yes,
no pattern should be there. They should behave in equal ground. They should behave very cordially with all the students, cordially with all the teachers.
Yes.
It's kind. No pattern should be observed in the residual plot.
Okay.
That's it. First, it will calculate M and C. Then it will plot the line. Then it will fit the data. That is called fitting the data. That putting the dot rangoli I am doing na, that is called fitting the data. This is called fitting.
Okay.
I am fitting the data. You see, it is highly random. This is permitted. The moment it starts taking some shape or regular pattern, similarity, then what is the meaning? No, if it is taking pattern, this model cannot work, madam. That's it. Because for example, I'm asking you to go and act in cinema.
Yeah,
we are a female. Why can't you and me can go and act in cinema? It is not suitable for our conscience. Because it's our nature. We are academicians. We want to be in the academic sector. Could you get me point?
Yes, ma'am.
So linear regression is the model cannot accept, cannot behave excellent for any pattern is found. That's all, nothing more. The moment the pattern comes into the matter, linear regression feels embarrassing. It cannot behave properly. It cannot predict properly. It cannot give you justification. One more session, if you ask me to handle, I can handle. But how I can act in film, I don't know.
Yes.
I cannot do my justice for acting in film. Because my characteristics meant for tend to be an academician.
Yes,
similarly, linear regression model not tend to predict that regular patterns or something like similarity, some pattern is formed, it is not fit enough.
Yes,
that is why we are concerned. It is not big a challenge at all. Just we need to understand. You see, you want to offer. You are kept on insisting. Come and act in my movie. I am financing. You are asking how many times? If you come and ask, also I will refuse you.
Yes.
Because that is not my character. That is not my bread and butter. I can be an academician only. My bread and it is like that resistance. These kind of things comes. I won't behave properly. That is what it is telling.
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, hello.
Yes, ma'am, tell me.
Ma'am, when we get the homo scedasticity, we have to again check the model, I mean the data, right? We have to again
You can't do, you can drop some variable or you can transform the data or you can do some feature engineering, little bit the behavior will be different.
Okay.
Three method. If at all you are getting, other thing is transform the data. This is one method. Or do the feature engineering, different feature engineering you do. Or drop some variable. Some variables.
Ma'am, if we drop variables, then our result will be like, it will be altered, right?
Yeah, definitely. Alter. Yeah. But with the homo scedasticity, what you can do?
The result won't change, ma'am, like if we do that.
Definitely will change, ma'am. But there is no other go, no.
Will that be efficient? I mean, that's what I mean.
We need to do. The different strategies we need to apply. We need to think of applying transformation and feature engineering. If at all that happens, then dropping some variable. All the three method you need to approach. Data science is all the time thinking in different angle, sitting and building with the same model for the same data again and again is your role, first of all. So you asked me if at all happened, what to do? For that I am answering. You need to transform the data or go for feature engineering, drop the value. Then if you ask, if I drop the value, what will happen? That I cannot answer. So technique only I can tell. Depending upon your situation, business context, size of the data, all matters. See, dropping the variable is not a big crime. So if you have more variable, you need to identify least importance variable, or you need to interpret each and every variable and its importance towards your business domain. If the value doesn't give, if the variable doesn't give any value, throw it away. Why you are worrying? If you have lesser variable, then you sit and cry. I agree. If you have huge variable, see the project what I have taken, 70 columns plus we are working. Why you are crying for that, dropping the variable? Understand?
Yes, yes, ma'am.
Yeah, if I am giving you to build a model only 6 variable, and that 6 variable also you are having this problem, heteroscedasticity problem, then what you can do? You do first genuinely transformation data, then go for feature engineering data, apply your knowledge. Then if you don't possess knowledge, you randomly do some dropping the variable. That variable, how you can drop? Go for correlation analysis. Scientifically, or relate the importance of the variable with the business domain, the problem statement, then drop the variable.
Okay.
There is no straightforward question, Kanna. This is the intelligent question. This batch, actually what I liked this batch, why it is dragging is all the time you guys are raising question, any doubt comes, none of you allowing me to proceed. So far now I haven't seen such a batch. I was even discussing with the Kannan sir. So this batch stops me whenever they have doubt also. And you are putting a lot of questions, whether that is suitable question, not in N aspect you are shooting out the question, that I like. But dropping the variable, don't worry for F 70, 20, 70, 80, 40 variables if you have. Don't cry and all. If you have 7 variable, 8 variable only, you need to sit and cry.
Mm-hmm.
Got the idea?
Yes, yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Any other question, Pooja ma'am?
No, no ma'am.
Yeah. With that, shall we sign off?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, I'll share right immediately this document. Please go through. And before coming to tomorrow's session, please look back that Jupyter Notebook up to exploratory data analysis, what we discussed, that outlier deduction. Then if possible, watch couple of video. NPTEL professors are talking. So many videos available. Just if you put linear regression, top 10 video, whichever you like, whomever you like, you just watch couple of videos. 3 blue, 1 brown. Just to visit that YouTube video. Just to go and visit. That visiting that YouTube video itself is a great honor for you. So visit. These are all the 3 assignment exercise. Mohammed, take
yes,
this
ma'am.
Assignment. You are loving assignment. I overload you. Wait. 3 blue, 1 brown. You see. Then next you watch minimum 3 videos on linear regression. Then the entire Jupyter Notebook you do. I will show you 1 minute. Hold on. I wanted to show you the formula for Z-score. Right from classification, Z-score I'll be using a lot many times. But even then, I want to show you right immediately.